Yo, what's good, YouTube? This is Jay from TNJ, and welcome back to the New Orleans Kings franchise. Last episode, we did go over the trade deadline here in Season 2, and we acquired some key pieces that will be key in making the push for the playoffs. Tyler Glasnow is the biggest one, along with Jake Cave. Both of those guys will contribute big time, one on the offense and one in the rotation. But we did get rid of Rogelio Armenteros, so that is a blow to us. But we do move up Forrest Whitley as well. He is 22 years old, the number 38 ranked prospect in baseball. Our only other ranked prospect is Jeremy Peña. Right now he's sitting there at number 6, but I just don't think he's ready. You know, he hasn't been putting up the numbers. It's not really pretty. And that just might be what he is. I mean, he hits about 260, 250, 260 in the minor leagues right now. And looking at the number one prospect, Robert Paulson, look at him on defense. I mean, that guy is a defensive monster. Good speed as well. He can also hit the ball pretty well for an 18-year-old. I mean, that is really, really good. So we actually go into this episode down in the division, 61-50. And we are in a four-game set with the Athletics right now. Right now, they are up 2-0 in this series. So maybe we can steal two back and tie this division right back up as we look at the debut of Tyler Glasnow on the mound. Let's see what he can do. So here he is facing this Oakland Athletics team. They have been competing there for the last two seasons as well. They have a couple of new guys in free agency, including this guy, Jason Hayward, who Glasnow will walk. And now they got a man on first base with one out. And here comes Matt Chapman, one of their best hitters up. He gets a chop at a third. Bodie throws a second, and we turn the double play. We will. There we go. And there we get out of the first inning. Glasnow, no damage done. As we move on to the bottom of the first inning, here is Marcus Semien, who hits a liner up the middle, and it's knocked down. Let's see if he can beat out the throw, and he will. And there we go. We got a man on first base here with one out, and that brings up Yasiel Puig. His average is at 291. Remember, he was leading the league in average at one point. And there, he swings that one up in the zone, and that one will be the first strikeout of the game for Dobnak. And that brings up Aguilar to the plate, hitting a little above what Puig was, and he gets a pitch on the inside part. He turns on it, and that one is not coming back. It's a homer, and that one will be his 20th home run of the season. That is tops on the Kings. And there we go, 2-0 here in the first inning. And Glasnow is out to a good start with a good lead. So now we move on to the top of the second. Here's Lariano at the plate. But he gets a hold of one, and that one is not coming back. That's a rocket over the left field wall. 437 feet, his 18th of the year. And he trims this lead down to just one as Austin Allen comes up. He hits a grounder to Scooter, but Scooter can't hold on to it. And he even had zero speed. He still couldn't throw him out. Man, Scooter, that's the one thing that I don't like about him. He doesn't have speed, and he just isn't that good of a fielder at all. That brings up the next batter, and look what happens. A homer. And that one, instead of being a one-run shot, it's a two-run shot. Steven Piscotty, he hits his 21st of the year, and now Oakland takes this lead 3-2. That brings up Tony Kemp, who is going to watch that one in the fifth as he starts it out with a walk. Glasnow. Here he is on the mound, ground ball, first base. Let's see if we can turn two, and we barely don't. And it looks like Jason Hayward comes up next here in the two hole. Let's see if we can get him out, but he hits a rocket right up the middle, and Billy Hamilton will come up throwing. Now they got guys on first and second here, one out in the fifth. Matt Chapman at the plate. He hits one to the right side, and that one is going to get through, and that is going to be another run surrendered by Glasnow. 4-2 here in this game. Is that brings up Austin Allen in the five hole, who hits one deep to left field, and that's just going to be a pop up to Tapia in left. And now with one out here, ground ball up the middle, and that is going to be a hit, 5-2. And here we go. Craig Stammen comes into the game, and let's see what he can do if he can get us out of this inning. And now 5-2, 3-2 count, two outs. Steven Piscotty at the plate. He drives one up the middle, and that one is going to be a run down from Billy Hamilton. And now we move on to the bottom of the fifth inning. Let's see if our offense can get us right back in this game. Here is our man Scooter. He hits one over the second baseman's head. That one will get all the way to the warning track, and he does not have the speed, only 25. But that one should be a triple. That's the one thing I don't like about Scooter. Hits the ball hard, but just does not have any type of speed. That brings up Billy Hamilton. He goes right back up the box, and that one will drive him in. So 5-3 here in the fifth inning. There's still a lot of time left in this game, a lot of innings left. We can come back. And now that brings up Ramiel Tapia here with two outs, and we're sending Billy Hamilton on the pitch, and it's just going to be a pop fly to left field. And this two-run lead will stay intact for the Oakland Athletics as that brings up Marcus Semien in the bottom of the sixth inning. Let's see if he can get us going. He hits a hard shot up the middle. Will it get down? And it does. So we got a man on first base here with no outs to start out the sixth inning as that brings up Yasiel Puig. His average is about at 287 right now, and he watches that one on the outside half. And now guys on first and second here, no outs. Jesus Aguilar, who's already went deep in this one. Can he give us the lead as he gets one right over the middle? And that one is going to be a shot to the gap. He goes the opposite field, and let's see if Semien can get on his horse and score from first, and he will. No throw home. It's 5-5 here. Still no outs here in the sixth inning with a man on second base. That's Aguilar, as that brings up Jake Cave, the new acquisition at the trade deadline. He gets one over the middle. He goes to Oppo as well. That one's down the left field line. It gets to the wall, and Aguilar will score 6-5 here at home. And there's still two outs here in this inning, as let's keep this inning going, and let's see what Billy Hamilton can do here. Two outs, man on first and second now. He will go right up the box, and it will be another RBI for him. And we will score Jake Cave from second base. And now it's 5-7. Let's see if we can just keep this inning going. So that brings up Ramiel Tapia here. He is 0-3 in this game, but he can keep this hit streak alive. And he does. He hits one to right field. And that one will get to the wall. There have been a lot of gap shots here in this game, as that one will score two. It's now 9-5 here as Tapia comes through. He is hitting extremely well since being moved up, as that brings up Marcus Semien. He goes deep to left field. Will it stay in the park? It does. It knocks off of the wall and left, and another run comes across. It's 10-5. What a comeback here in the sixth inning. As let's see if Puig can keep it going. Everybody's hitting the ball well. He hits one to right field, but it is snagged by the first baseman, and that's how this inning will end. But we do add on about seven runs in that inning. And now here comes Jake Cave in the seventh. Guys on first and second. He hits the ball hard up the middle, and it will get down. And let's see if we will send the runner. No, we won't. So now base is loaded. One out here in the seventh inning. As Jake Cave, he's hitting the ball well so far as well. And now Scooter Jeanette, he comes up. He's 1-for-2 in this game with that double earlier. And he checks swings on an inside pitch. And that is going to be ball four. So that one will walk a run in. It is now 11-6 as that brings up Billy Hamilton. Bases loaded. He's hitting the ball well. And he goes the opposite field. And it does get down. It will score two. And that one will be a 13-6 lead here in the seventh. What an offensive output by the Kings at home. And now Tapia. He's 1-for-4. Can you make it 2-for-5 with a man in scoring position here? And he gets one over the middle, and he hits one hard. That one will get down, and we will send Scooter at second, and he will score. It's 14-6. Can we keep these runs going? We're still in the seventh inning here with one out. That brings up Marcus Semien, 3-for-4. Can he make it 4-for-5? He gets an inside pitch and turns on it. Another gap shot. And wow, what an offensive output by this Kings offense. 16-6 now. Wow. This is an explosion. This is a way to make a statement on the first place leading Oakland Athletics. As here comes Yasiel Puig to the plate. He is 0-for-3 in this game. He is the lone guy yet to get a hit so far. And with a man on second base, he won't. It's going to be a swing and miss. He goes 0-for-4. And that brings up Jesus Aguilar, who's already went deep in this one, and a double 2-for-4 so far. Donnie Hart on the mound for the Athletics, and he will just pop out to right field. But a big two innings for us, And now we have a very sizable lead as that brings us to the ninth inning in a 17-10 lead. Here is Jason Hayward at the plate. And Joe Smith, last year's closer, on the mound to close us out. That's not really a save, but he does get the strikeout, and we do get the victory here as we do close the gap with the Oakland Athletics, 17-10 in that game. So we did have some people we called up. Zach Cozart was one of them. I wanted to get him some burn as well because we need some infield depth. We just don't have that in our organization at all right now. That's the one thing that's really plaguing us as far as our future goes. We don't really have any promising second baseman. Even Jeremy Pena, he's the number six prospect in baseball, but he's not tearing the ball off the cover at all at the minor league level. He's just doing decent. So I can't really count on him to be moved up soon. He has good attributes, obviously, but you've seen what happens to guys when they get called up early. Corey Lee, he wasn't called up early, but he was off to a hot start. Now he's struggling, hitting about 230. So the Athletics do get the victory in the next game. So they actually win 3 of 4, and their two-game lead still remains in the division. And now, next game, we will see Forrest Whitley. He goes straight from AA to the major leagues. Last year, he was at AAA, so I didn't think I need to see him there. And I decided to move him up in favor of Jace Vines, who we did trade, and then also Teddy Pelletitis, and one of our best guys in our organization, Jimmy Pelko, the lefty. So let's see what Forrest Whitley has. So let's start out here in the first inning facing this Seattle Mariners team who has been a bottom feeder just like us last 2 years, but now we're back and we're competing for the division and they are still struggling. So Forrest Whitley does give up a hit there to start out the game, but another ground ball to Semien. This one will be the first out of the inning. And now that brings up Mitch Haniger in the three spot. He will watch one on the inside part of the plate. Forrest Whitley may have missed his spot on that one on the changeup, but it's still nonetheless a strikeout. That brings up Dom Thompson-Williams, who hits one to left field, and he already gave up two hits here in the first inning. Let's see if he can get out of this jam with Evan White at the plate. Hitting 254, he's watching. That's strike three. Two backwards Ks in the first inning, and let's see if we can keep this going into the second. Here is Leonis Martin at the plate. He will swing and miss. He is the former New Orleans King, now playing for the Mariners. And let's see, Lopes, he's swinging and missing as well. You can see his best pitch is that slider. I love to use it. Here is Mitch Haniger at the plate. It's just a ground ball right back to him. He's looking good in the first three innings. As now we move on to the fourth, Evan White at the plate. Let's see what he can do. He hits one to the gap, and that one will get to the wall. Let's see, White's got decent speed with 70 as a first baseman, and he will stand up with a double here. And let's see if Forrest Whitley can get out of this jam. Martin at the plate again. He's swinging and missing, and he strikes out for the second time this game. Whitley's fifth strikeout of the game, and that brings up Tom Murphy, the catcher. Strike three. Six strikeouts here in his debut through his first four innings. And now we move on to the fifth inning. Here is Tim Lopes, who's already struck out once. And he watches that one on the outside part. That was a close slider. I'm surprised he stayed away from that one. But he won't stay away from the next one. Strike three. Seven strikeouts here in his debut. That one brings us to the top of the lineup. Sam Haggerty at the plate. He's swinging and missing, making eight strikeouts. And look at this. They are throwing a no-hitter against us, but Forrest Whitley is dominant so far, but in the sixth, he leaves one over the middle of the plate, and Mitch Haniger does not miss. That's a home run, his 20th of the year, and now they take the 1-0 lead, but let's see if Whitley can settle down here on the mound after giving up that big fly. He will. That's his ninth strikeout, making nine. Evan White at the plate. Let's see, with two outs, he hits one hard to first base, but it's caught. Whitley looks good. Nine strikeouts here through six. And now we move on to the seventh. Leonis Martin at the plate. And here we go. He's going through seven. Can he get that 10th strikeout? Martin hits one deep. And that one is carrying. It is going to be gone. That one was crushed. 430 feet. And now it's a 3-2 game as our offense does give us a few runs to work with. But let's see if Whitley can settle down. He's at 92 pitches, ground ball to Scooter, and he gets out of the seventh inning. And let's see if he keeps it going. But no, it looks like he was pulled after that inning. A great first performance by him. 9 strikeouts through 7 innings. Couldn't ask for better. Let's see if our team can close it out. And let's see if they get some more run support. And they do in the 8th. They tack on 2 more runs. And we go on to win the game. And Forrest Whitley gets the win as well. Great debut by him. I am excited for his future. 9 strikeouts, 6 hits, 2 earned runs, 0 walks. That's what you like to see. And we get the victory versus the Seattle Mariners. And I wanted to see the debuts of those two guys. And after that win, we actually tie up the Athletics. As we won the last 2, they lost the last 2. This is going to be a dance till the end. We're going to be battling for this division all month long, all the way to the end of the season. We actually end the season in a 3-game set with the Athletics, then a 3-game set with the Angels, who are right there. They're a half game back. So this is going to be an interesting race for this AL West title. So hit subscribe, hit that like button. Next episode, we will be getting closer and closer to the end of the season. So stay tuned. Let's get it. Let's go. The ones who don't deserve it seem to be the ones that get it. The ones who speak the truth never get the recognition. But the ones that act foolish seem to get all the attention. It don't matter though, yeah. And it don't even matter though, nope. Hey, it don't even matter.